Hey guys, Shweta here and welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be doing a video where I will be telling you guys the difference between a makeup sponge and a silicone puff. So let's get started with the video. I came across makeup sponges like in 2015 when I started my YouTube channel and I started vlogging. So at that point of time I did come across, and makeup sponges have been my favorite since then, and I have always used makeup sponges for applying my foundation, concealer, contour, everything. I always use a makeup sponge. But again, after makeup sponge, there was a time when there's something special that came up, and that was a silicone puff which went viral, and I got my hands on it a few days ago, and I haven't used a silicone puff ever, so it's the first time I'm using it. But I wanted to show you guys what is the difference between the application of the two things and which of the ones that you should go for. So let's get just started with the video. So for the makeup sponge, I'll be using my favorite, which is the YPP makeup sponge applicator, and this has been my favorite makeup sponge since the time I got my hands on it. This product has really revolutionized the way I see makeup sponges in India, because in India the makeup sponges that are available are generally very low quality sponges. While I was shopping a few days ago, I got my hands on this puff set by Ginger. This is a lifestyle brand called Ginger, which is really popular in India. So anyway, I'll be just using one of them. There are two in this packet. YPP makeup sponge costs you ₹1200 for one piece, while this makeup puff set costs you ₹179 for two pieces. So there's a huge difference. This is the makeup sponge which I'll be using for this video, and I purposely try to use this because I feel it's a really superior quality and it can actually show you the proper coverage that it gives. So basically these two things separately give two different coverages, and that's why it's so important to know how it differs. Firstly, this sponge here, I have already wet the sponge and it has doubled its size, and you guys can see this is a really soft sponge, and what I love about it is you can clean it and reuse it again and again and again. I have been using it since over a year now and I'm so happy about it. So this is something that gives me that flawless makeup finish. The silicone sponge I'll be using is like this. It looks like this. It's basically a transparent silicone puff which is really soft, as you guys can see. It is very, very soft and squishy actually, and it's really, really, really cool to play with. And I'm like really interesting. It's so spongy and soft. But again, what is interesting about this puff is makeup sponges generally are way more usable in terms of the usage because it has pores which helps it blend it so well. But the silicone puff will not have any kind of pores. It's just plain kind of a plasticky finish, so I don't know how much blending it will give. So I want to see how interesting this thing is and how much coverage it gives. So I will be using one side of my face for the sponge and the other side of the face for the puff, and I will be using my favorite Fit Me foundation, and today I'll be using it in the shade 230, which is natural buff. So I'll be using like half of the face. I'll be using this side of my face, and for this side of my face I will be using the puff. This is the makeup sponge by YPP and this is the silicone puff by Ginger. So let's just do that. Thing is, there are different ways in which you can use these products for applying your foundation. Generally some people actually pour the foundation over it and then use it, but I prefer to use the foundation on my face, dot it up, and then use it with the sponge or whatever applicator I'm using, because I feel that that way I can control on how much product I want to place on each of my spot on the face. Like if there's a spot particular I want to cover, I will put more foundation on that side, and maybe if there's a place which is more lightly pigmented on my face, I'll put less of the foundation on it. So you can basically control it. Firstly, I will be using the YPP makeup applicator. So you guys can see this gives a medium coverage on my face that I've used with this sponge, and what I love about it is very easy to use and blends it pretty well. That's why I'm actually concerned about the puff, because it is plasticky, it doesn't have pores, so I don't know how much it will blend. the basic difference that you guys can see is the coverage. This side of my face looks more liquidy than this side of my face. This looks more polished. This looks more like the product has gone in my pores and kind of made it a more matte finish than this one. This looks way more almost like you've just painted something. So it looks a little bit more on the grassy side. I don't like the basic application. So overall, you guys can see that the coverage is really nice. It's quite a high coverage than the puff. The puff gives a more medium coverage. This is towards medium to high coverage. So even the spots that were, they actually are completely covered with the foundation, which is the good thing that I found about the silicone puff. But it hasn't blended properly at all. It just looks painted on my face, which gives it a very, very superficial kind of a finish on my face, and it looks as if there's something that I haven't done with the foundation. Like I could have blended it with something, and it just looks unblended and unpolished. So that way the coverage is high, but the blending is really, really not there, which is a big disappointment for me. Another thing that I faced while using it is, though it's very easy to use towards the corner because of the shape of the puff, the biggest problem that I faced is the staining. Because it is a silicone puff, it's almost like using plastic, and because of that the puff is completely stained. And what happens, even when you're putting your fingers on it, your fingers are getting completely stained out of using it. So my right fingers are almost all stained with the foundation, so it is a big problem because now I have to go back and wash my hands, and it's a big problem in that way. Now with the sponge, you can see it's more blended, it's more easy. I don't get the foundation on my hand, but here I do get a lot of foundation on my hand. So huge difficulty with that. So guys, you have seen the application of both the sponge and the silicone puff, and now you guys know what is the difference between the two. Now if I have to give my final thoughts on this, I would still say that I really, really enjoy using the sponge more than I use the silicone puff, because the sponge gives me a very nice blended nice application and finish, which the puff is not able to give because of its surface issues and the material that it is made from. Yeah, the basic thing that I really loved about using the silicone puff is definitely the coverage. If you have spots or dark spots or pigmentation on your face, this will actually help you to cover up that part, and your spots actually are gone within seconds. Again, it also depends on the type of foundation that you're using. There is one trick that you guys can do if you have this sponge or you want to use this sponge. I would say that you can actually buy this sponge for getting like the initial coverage part. For example, whenever you're starting using a foundation on your face while going to an event or something where you want to hide your spots, you want to hide your face pigmentation, what you can do is you can actually use this first and actually basically try to hide all the spots and pigmented parts on your face, and then actually use the sponge to blend it properly so that it gives you a flawless finish. You can actually double layer your face and it will make it look more flawless and well finished and also well covered. So if I have to give a rating to this, I will be giving a 9 out of 10 to the sponge and almost like a 7 out of 10 to the puff. So guys, that was it for my video, and hope you guys really liked it. If you did, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. Please press on the subscription button below to subscribe to my channels. A lot of new videos are coming soon, and I'm really sorry I'm pretty late about with the videos, and I just wanted to wish you a happy new year, and hope 2018 brings a lot of positivity and happiness and peace in your lives. And do let me know if you have any video requests or you want to ask anything about the video. Just in the comment section below, you can comment down and I try to reply it as soon as possible. Hope you guys are really having a great January ahead, and yay to a lot of new starts this year. So be happy, be peaceful, love beauty, love fashion. Ciao.